This is the demonstration of a first prototype of the integration of PyFlow, a node editor running in Qt with FreeCAD. The source is by Ilga Lunin and GitHub here, and I have done some modification to get it running in some windows inside of FreeCAD. So let's start. We start with FreeCAD with the common official version. I think here we have release 16,093. Okay, we start in with a script and we load a file and a node configuration. In this case, in the file I have some geometry, some objects to run, and here I have the node editor window this way. So, and several nodes. I have a timer, I have a clock which gives me a parameter, and then I have some nodes connected. And when I go to the timer and select it, here is a property window of the nodes of the node editor. And let's start. I start execute, and in this moment it starts, and I see here there is a movement of this object. I get here some output, and here is the step size, the interval of the animation, so I can make it a little bit faster. I change this value down and stand a reset, and now it becomes faster. And if I go to zero and re-execute, I get a real-time animation in this case. So here we have the FreeCAD placement, and there are some parameters, x, y, z, and the arc of the placement. And here's the object. At the moment I have the cylinder, and I can replace it by another object, say the box. So if I change the name, it runs. This is still a dialog from PyFlow, and not so we still do not have the widgets to get a selection of the objects of the object tree, but this can be done in future. So we see here all the parameters x, y, and z are in this case triggered by these nodes. Arc is free editable, and so I can change the arc. And if we look at the movement of the cube, we see there is a rotation. This is a free parameter. The other work like expressions in the common FreeCAD environment. So the next thing what we have here the dependency with sine and cosine functions, and I have here a factor for the y coordinate, and now I can change the factor. And in this case, I will normalize the view. If I change the factor, the ellipse is scaled in y direction. And the same I can do in this case here with the parameter for the x direction. For Z, I do not have an animation, I only have here a float. And if I select this and we look at the animation, we can change this parameter. Okay, so it works always when I click on such a node. I get here the property tab for this node. And this parameter tab is a dock window, so it can be placed somewhere in on the screen. And the same we have here for the node editor, so I can take the node editor and make it larger and put it onto another screen. Oh. So, and we can zoom in and zoom out in the node editor. Okay, this is the first version. So next up, I will start to make some changes inside to change the labels and so on and to work with groups.